Hello, my name is William Porter, and welcome to my YouTube channel, Simply The Culinarian. Today I'm going to be showing you how to make one of my favorite dishes, spicy Thai basil fried rice. Hey Google, what is Thai basil fried rice?
On the website food52.com, they say, Thai basil fried rice, better than your go to takeout order. Not your typical fried rice, this Thai-style version is flavored with chili peppers and fish sauce, then perfumed with fragrant Thai basil. On one of those days when you don't want to put together a fancy dish, there's always fried rice.
All right, so with any Asian dish, you always want to make sure you have all of your ingredients prepped ahead of time. That is very important because there is no going back. Asian dishes tend to cook very quickly in a very high heated wok. So before you could even start, you must have some cold cooked jasmine rice. That is very important that this rice is cold. All fried rices start with cold cooked rice. Rice that is too hot will make your rice pull out too much starch and it'll be very, very gummy. So, for our protein, we're gonna be using some cut up chicken, some deveined cleaned raw shrimp, and some chopped sirloin steak. To flavor our proteins, we're gonna be using this Thai McCormick bouillon cubes. I picked them up at Walmart, they're very inexpensive. This is my first time trying them. I normally use something else, but what the heck. You're gonna need about a tablespoon of chopped garlic. I have just a little bit of sliced serrano pepper. You can add as much as you like depending on your heat tolerance level. Some chopped peppers and onions. Some matchstick carrots. I have a lightly beaten egg. I have some fish sauce, some dark soy sauce, some sugar, and some sliced scallions. Also, I have some Thai basil. Now, you can use regular basil, but Thai basil is very important for this meal. It has a natural sweeter flavor. See, it's not like regular basil. It has like a reddish vein. It's really good, and it really brings out a lot of flavor in this dish. So, let's get started. I'm gonna start with some oil and our hot wok. I'm gonna add some of our bouillon cube. Just gonna break that up. I just want to get a nice feel on this. I don't want to overcook it. We're going to cook it more as it adds to the skillet. Just gonna keep going with our next protein. We're gonna add a little bit more oil. Add another piece. I chopped that one bouillon cube up into a couple pieces because I'm only using a little bit of meat. I think one cube will cook season a pound of meat. Add a little bit more oil to this. That seasoning smells good. It's definitely worth the try. Start with some more oil. I'm gonna be a little generous this time with the oil. We'll start with our garlic. From there, I'm gonna add my serrano. The serrano will kind of spice that oil for you. Then from there, I'm going to add my onions and peppers. You can smell those serranos. Smells like heat. You want to keep everything moving because you don't want that garlic to sit and burn. Burn garlic is not a good flavor. With the vegetables, you just want to cook them slightly till they're a little bit transparent because you don't want to cook them to the point where they're too mushy. this point, you can go ahead and add your matchstick carrots. I also believe in seasoning in layers. I'm going to salt and pepper to my vegetables. Jasmine rice. Now make sure you break it up a little bit. This is another time where you can add more salt and pepper to your rice. Kind of want to heat it up. Now we're going to add our protein back to the skillet. Like to push all my rice to the side. Add me a little bit more oil right here to the corner of your skillet. And I like to toss that egg in right there. And I like to get it on a jump start scramble. Really use the side of your wok. A lot of the heat is on the side. Let's break it up into the egg. I only use one egg. You can use two if you like a lot of egg in your rice. Smelling good. Fish sauce, our soy sauce, and that about a 2 tablespoons of white sugar, I would say. Scallions. And from here you can cut off your heat. All right. I'm going to take another scallion. And we're gonna cut some long cuts on the bias. Smells so good, y'all. I love this stuff. going to garnish it with your scallions. And there you have it. Oh, I almost forgot a step. Out of step, that's all right. It's my first recording, it happens. What we're gonna do, we're just gonna replay it. You normally add the basil right at the end just so we can wilt it just a little bit. And there you have it. Spicy Thai basil fried rice. Well, that was my show. Thanks for watching. And tune into the next show. You never know what's going to be next. Just like, comment, share. And also throw in the comments, throw some things you would like to see me cook. Some of your favorite meals or things you've wanted to try that you've never tried. Maybe I might have tried it before. I don't know. All right. Thanks for watching. Bye.